Father Almighty, hearts and words are not enough to say how grateful we are for making it possible for us to see today. Most especially, in remembrance of our Father who departed, who he placed you to come home. We are doing this to honor you in his life, even when he is gone. I pray, Father, as we gather at your feet this evening to sing, let the host of heaven attend to us this day. In the name of God the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Thou whose almighty word, by John Marriott, 1780 till 1825. And educated at Rugby and Christ Church, Oxford. He was the second of two who obtained honors in the schools in 1802. First year in which there was a public examination for honors at Oxford. He was also a student at Christ Church, and for about 2 years a private tutor in the family of the Duke of Wellington. The Duke presented him to the rectory of Church Lawford, Warwickshire. This he retained to his death, although his wife's health compelled him to reside in Devonshire, where he was successively curate of St. Lawrence and other parishes in Exeter and Brockstyth, near Exeter, where he died March 31st, 1825. I enjoy you to sing this song, Lost Him.
Supported missions and the British Bible Society. published 11 volumes of poetry, mainly two, and at least 400 hymns. Some critics judge his scheme texts to be equal in quality to those of Isaac Watts and Charles Wesley. Many were published in Thomas Cotterill's Selection of Poems and Hymns, 1819 edition, and in Montgomery's own Songs of Zion, 1822, Christian Psalms, 1825, and Original Hymns, 1853. Beloved, can you join me in singing these songs of praise?
Device as a stair step technique, The vocabulary connects each line as the reader moves through the psalm, 7:30, and connects the main theme over the course of the poetic movements. Psalm 121 opens with the confidence assertion that God will be his helper, and lift up my eyes to the mountains. Tucker explains mountains has been interpreted negatively as treacherous and dangerous path, the places at which false gods were worshipped, or possibly as Zion or the hills surrounding Zion. When your world turns dark and your journey turns rugged, where do you go? You turn to help. What is your source? And for the confidence you need to face the headwind of life. Psalm 121 encourages all in such times. It reminds us where our help comes from and infuses us with confidence. My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and the earth. Beloved, please join me and others here in reading Psalm 121.
Arose out of the water's involvement in the life of the Black Old Diocese.
where he has served all his ministerial life. The Bishop of the Diocese made a call to mission to arouse the parish's responsibility in this field. The hymn was written for these meetings with the 4 points being taken up in turn in the four inner verses. It was immediately seized upon for wider use and has become something of a standard hymn in our books. The composer was a highly enthusiastic proponent of the works of the great classical German composers.
Thank you. chapter 3, verses 15 to 17.
And let the
peace of God rule in your hearts, that dwell in you richly in all wisdom, teaching and admonishing one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing with grace in your hearts to the Lord. And whatever you do in word or deed, do all in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. This is the word of God.
The first rule of the evening to be given to us by gentleman and so also.
by Dottrich Finnick. Dottrich Finnick, D.D., was born in London on June 26, 1702. Grandfather was one of the ministers under the Commonwealth, who were ejected in 1662. His father was a London clergyman. He was offered by the Duchess of Bedford, a university training for the nation, the Church of England, but declined it. Entered his identity, Dennis Non-Performance Seminary at Ipoh Institute. Preached his first sermon at Hinckley, to which Mr. Jennings had brought his academy. In 1723, he was chosen pastor by Ipoh. In 1725, he changed his residence to Market Hill, still ministering at Ipoh. The second work of his life as a preceptor and divine began in 1723. He said to be born in 1759, where he died October 26, the same year. He was presented with a CD degree at the University of Aberdeen. His dream as a divine, combined with his wide sympathies and gentle and affected goodness, won for him the friendship of Lords, Colonel Gardner and Harvey, and the esteem of Sita and Warburton. He welcomed the work of Wesley Whitefield and entertained the latter on his visit to the county. His rise and progress of the vision made him so, and the family expositor, who did good work in their day. After Dr. Dodge's death, he seems to have worked by his friend, John Orton, in 1754.
And as such received his board and education free. In 1726, Charles Wesley was elected to Westminster Fellowship at Christ Church, Oxford, where he took his degree in 1729 and became a college tutor. In the early part of the same year, his religious impressions were much deepened, and he became one of the first canon of Oxford Methodists. In 1735, he went with his brother John to Georgia and sent him to George Ogilvie Thorpe. Having before set out, received deacons and raised orders on two successful Sundays, his stay in Georgia was very short. He returned to England in 1736, and in 1737 came under the influence of Port Zinzendorf and the Moravians, especially of that remarkable man who has so large a share in holding the first place career, Peter Bonner, and also of a Mr. Bray, a brazier in Little Britain. Henceforth, his work was identified with that of his brother John, and he became an indefatigable itinerant and field preacher. On April 8, 1749, he married Sarah Gibbon. His marriage and that of his brother John was the most happy one. Each were as frequent as ever until the year 1756, when he ceased to itinerate and nearly devoted himself to the care of the societies in London and Bristol. He died in London March 29, 1788, and was buried in Marylebone Churchyard. John May singing this song of praise. Thank you.
Thank you. 1963 to 1962, Archdeacon of Norwich, 1973 to 1981, the Bishop of Thetford, Norfolk, from 1981 until his retirement in 1992. He also edited a Christian magazine, Crusade, which was founded after Billy Graham's 1955 London Crusade. Douglas Haig began writing comic verse while a student in Cambridge. He did not begin to write hymns until the 1960s. Many of his several hundred hymn texts have been collected in gifts. Douglas Haig also served on various editorial committees, including the committee that published Psalm Praise, 1973. Shall we all sing joyfully the four stanzas of this song?
Thank you. have no tongues. It will never be sufficient to pay for all the Lord has done. And so with a thanks song today, with the sound of thanksgiving, we will lift our voice to the one who was, who is, and is to come. Our help in ages past. Hallelujah.
Indicate that they were moved probably about 84.
one and one the three. Let us sing the fourth stanza.
this evening to give you thanks. Father, we know that you answer all prayers in accord with your will. Grant unto your children in excess of their asking. Tonight, from the children of light, banish all forms of darkness. For the love of your only Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. And now unto him who is able to keep you from falling and to present you faultless before the throne of grace, be all honor, glory to me.